Hello, my name is Robert Dean Steele, and this is your daily Bible class. Now, we're looking at 1 John chapter 4, verses 1 to 4, and this is what it says here. John says, "My dear friends, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see whether they are of God, because many false prophets have gone into the world." So here is John warning and exhorting his audience and us today about the fact that we need to be able to test every spirit, every false prophet. We need to test everything. So what do we test them with? Well, first of all, we always test, does this individual, does this philosophy, does this doctrine lift up Jesus Christ? Jesus said, he says, "If I be lifted up, all men will be drawn unto me." So the first test is, does this person, does this philosophy, does this teaching always point to Jesus Christ? Now the Holy Spirit, he is the one who's behind the truth. And the Holy Spirit always takes that which he hears and passes it unto us. And the number one priority and aim of the Holy Spirit is to point people to Jesus Christ. Because Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and no one can come to the Father but by him. Number two, does it line up with the bulk of Scripture? Now we're not to take just one piece of Scripture and plant ourselves on it and say, this is the truth and there's no other truth. We need to look from Genesis to Revelation. Did you know that there are 300 Old Testament scriptures about Jesus Christ? And those scriptures all pointed to his Messiahship. It all pointed to the fact that he was the Son of God, God with a face. He was the perfect representation of God. He was the perfect union of the divine and as well the natural. You know what? Jesus Christ was God with a face. And so not only does the Bible show that, but the Bible also tells us that Jesus Christ is coming back. So many scriptures in the Old Testament and New Testament talk about Jesus Christ coming back. The second test always has to be with the Scripture. And the third test always has to be, it points towards the death, the burial, the resurrection of Jesus Christ, also his broken body and shed blood. There are just three of them. There are many, many other tests that we should be looking at as well. Then he goes on to say this. This is how you recognize the Spirit of God. Now this is very serious. Every spirit acknowledges that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh, or Jesus Christ is from God. That's the absolute test. Jesus Christ is who he said he was. Jesus Christ came in the flesh. Jesus Christ was the incarnation of God. Jesus Christ always did what the will of the Father is. Those false cults, they'll often say, well, we believe that Jesus Christ is the creation of God, but he isn't God. Or they may say, well, you know what happened was Jesus Christ came into the flesh, but then when Jesus Christ was on the cross, the spirit part of Jesus Christ basically ascended. Or they'll say things like, well, Jesus is the younger brother of Satan. These are all cults. Jesus Christ is God. He was the perfect union of God and man. He is the incarnation. He was virgin born. It all points to Jesus Christ. And then it goes on this, and every spirit that does not acknowledge Jesus is from God, that spirit is the spirit of Antichrist, which you have heard is coming and even now is all in the world. It's all about Jesus Christ. What you do with Jesus Christ determines what kind of religion, what kind of focus is happening at that time. The false cults will always bring Jesus down to a certain level. Or the false cults will come along and say, well, Jesus Christ was this, but you need another book. Or you need another testament of Jesus Christ. Or the Bible isn't quite correct, so you need our particular version of the Bible. Or they'll say, you know, the Bible is good, but you also need this book, and this book. What happens is they don't take Jesus Christ of the Bible. And you know what they are? That's the spirit of Antichrist. It's the spirit that is already in the world. He says the spirit of Antichrist is already in the world. And he says you need to test it. You need to make sure that what is being said is the truth. And the central focus of that truth is Jesus Christ. It is what you do with Jesus Christ that's the most important thing. That's what John wants to get across, and that's what we want to get across to you today. My name is Robert Dean Steele. This is your daily Bible class, and you have yourself a great and godly day.